Good evening, folks. Joe here with the 2017 Passat SEL Premium. This is as fully loaded as you can get one right here. Got every option. This is our car that we picked up after the diesel buyback on our 14 Passat diesel. So when we cashed it in, we just went ahead and picked up one of these, got a really good discount on it. Plus Volkswagen gave us stupid money for the 2014 Passat diesel. But anyway, like I said, this is top of the line. It's getting dark. Let's take a little drive. All right, of course, push button start for Volkswagen is down here by the gear shifter. All right. Now, I've had a Passat, I've had a 15, I've got a fairly loaded Golf Sport Wagon, but this Premium is to an all new level. This has actual leather seats instead of the Volkswagen VTEC leatherette. This car also has a couple other features that are cool. It's got power folding mirrors. It's got adaptive cruise control. It has self-parking right here with this button you see right here with the P in the steering wheel. It will self-park itself. There's my crazy kids. And, they're crazy. And of course, it's got blind spot monitoring, the braking mitigation, but probably the two coolest features that I didn't even know they offered was the self-parking feature. I did not know Volkswagen offered that, and I didn't know they offered power folding mirrors, so that's pretty cool. This is basically the same steering wheel that's in my Golf Sport Wagon. Nothing really different there. Let's put on our seatbelt. This does have a little updated head unit there. As you can see, there's the navigation. I like what they've done. I've seen this in other Passat reviews, is this kind of faux aluminum metal look that is textured. It looks real nice. You know, just adds a, you know, this black is pretty, it's pretty black. So that kind of helps break up some of the blackness. The wood, this is wood grain. I don't know if this really shows up in the camera. It comes down through here, across here, and on around the cup holders. And it's like a dark, you know, a real dark charcoal wood grain wood. But, yeah, this car is, this is the top of the line, and it's, I tell you, I really miss the torque of that diesel, especially when it comes to passing on the freeway and such. But around town, hey, this thing gets about great. The 1.8 TSI engine is just so hard to beat. Plus, this 6-speed automatic with a lockup torque converter is just, it shifts so much better than a DSG. The DSG and the diesel would sometimes give you kind of a hunching sensation from a dead stop. This transmission is very smooth, very slick. I mean, for such a big car, this engine moves this car very nicely. I mean, it's not fast. You know, I think 0 to 60 times or somewhere around, you know, 8 seconds or maybe it's 7.8, 8 seconds, somewhere in there. But it's great. Average fuel economy. I've been averaging I've been averaging right around 25 to 26 in my golf. And in this car, as you can see, I'm averaging 20 even. But this has been strictly just around town. This car has not been on any road trips yet. It's only, you know, run up 20 miles to Chattanooga and back two times. So, plus, with only 2,700 miles on it, I think, let's see, we've had this thing 3 months now. You know, it'll go up. My Golf is about 9 months, 9-10 months old. It stuck around 20 for a while, and then it started easing up to about, you know, 25, 26. Yeah, those aren't spectacular numbers. But, you know, when you have a pretty lead foot like I do, I mean, this 1.8 TSI is so much fun just to wind out. Even though it doesn't have a ton of power, I'm going to drop it down into sport mode here. And we're running 35, and I'm just going to floor it right now. Okay. Okay, there's 65. So, you know, it still gets up and goes pretty good, but, you know, it's not going to break your neck. Good stereo. Not sure what the hell. What is that? Let's get over here to some. Oh, the wife's been listening to some 60s music. Man, she's smoking grass. Broadway. This is typical of her, my daughter. But this car does have the Fender audio right up here in the corner. It says Fender. Has the Fender audio. Sounds really good. The one thing I love about the Passat, it is just so extremely smooth. I mean, the ride is so smooth. Yet, it still has a hint of that, you know, German feel, like an old Mercedes, or you know, I've heard some reviewers talk about, oh, the Passat's been Americanized, and you know, it's a big car, and it's got that Buick kind of feel now, and you know, maybe, yeah, a little bit of that is true, but the steering is, you know, tracks dead straight. It responds well to your inputs. I think it has a great feel. The steering wheel itself feels great. It has leather wrapped. And with them updating it this past year, got the flat bottom, putting your controls up here. It's a good looking steering wheel. Yeah, this body design is aging, but I think it's aging pretty well, you know, gracefully, I guess you could call it. I'll be anxious to see if there's a, you know, all new 2018 Passat, but, you know, I'd be curious to see how all new it is. But of course, it's got heated seats. It's got your dual zone climate controls. Power passenger seat. And another feature that I had not seen, it wasn't on our SEL Passat diesel or 14, but this one has heated rear seats. So, you know, that's cool. Nice feature. Of course, you got your glass sunroof, your VW Carnet. I think this car drives better, oops, sorry, than our 14 TDI as far as steering goes. We had some alignment problems with that car. I constantly, I mean, I think in the time we owned it, it had about 33,000 miles on it. I think I had 3 alignments during the time. It seemed to always be wanting to pull one way or another. Alright, let's get us a little run here. Alright, there's 60, and there's a big ass truck. Now, on coarse pavement, you get a little bit of noise. But as soon as the road smooths out, it settles into a pretty nice cruise. Some pretty rough pavement right here. Let me get over one lane to the smoother lane. Miles an hour, you're turning about 2300 RPM. That's exactly what my Golf Sport Wagon turns at 80, 2300 RPM. But this car will cruise all day at, I mean, if you 90, 100, 110. I mean, whatever. It's happy. The faster you go, the more secure it feels and the more it kind of settles in and hunkers down. Kind of reminds me again, like I said, of an old Mercedes. You know, the faster I went in my Mercedes E320, the more, you know, the more buckled down it felt. It felt like, you know, was riding on rails on the interstate. Great car. But yeah, you can win the sticker on a fully loaded SEL gas premium like this is about 32, 33. We got it for a little under 30 for 29. And I probably could have pushed a little harder, but I was dealing a little bit with a deadline of turning in the diesel Passat, getting the maximum amount of money for it, and me making a promise to, hey, I'll buy another Passat, I'm not going to leave you guys. And they didn't have the two SEL premiums. It seems like the popular Passat right now is just the SE trim, because the SE trim gives you the leatherette, it gives you heated seats, it gives you a power driver seat, and it gives you a sunroof, and it gives you this basic same, you know, radio, not the fender, but pretty much the same setup and system with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Now, and the SE does not come with navigation, but when you have Apple CarPlay, you don't need navigation. So I only had two choices, a choice of a white one with black interior or a black one with a black interior. And I thought I'd go with the black on black. It looks really sharp when it's cleaned up. I thought I'd give it a shot. And, see if I enjoy it for the next 3 years. If I keep it that long. Yeah, this car drives great. I'm trying to think, what else? Like I said, a lot of people have done a lot of reviews on these. And, you know, you got your nice cubby down there with the cigarette outlet there. You have, finally they've put a USB in here and another 12 volt outlet and an auxiliary input. This is to do your Apple CarPlay or Android Auto. Sunroof. Just twist the knob like an old Audi. There you go. It's kind of a small sunroof, but it's a sunroof nonetheless. Volkswagen has the best adaptive cruise control, and the reason why I say that is it will work all the way down to 1 mile per hour. It does not cancel itself out at, you know, 19 miles per hour like many cars do. It will work all the way down to 1 mile per hour, which is fantastic in stop and go traffic. As long as the traffic's moving, if you're creeping along at 2 miles an hour, it'll keep you a nice distance, 2 miles an hour. When we get up to speed here, I'll show you again how it kind of works here. God, the interstate's busy tonight, Friday night. I guess people are, oh, it is Father's Day weekend. People may be traveling to go see their families, their papas, big papas. Alright, so set the cruise on 70. Oh, I think I turned it off. There we go. Alright, set the cruise on 70. Okay. Now you can see the little car. You can see the little car there. You can adjust how close you want to get to somebody, or you press the center button and you can really push a car out about 6 or 7 car lengths. I tend to keep it about right there because at freeway speeds, that will put you about 1.5 car lengths from the car in front of you. So I've just bumped the cruise up to 85. Alright, and it senses this Suburban up here in front of us. And now it's going to take over. Again, I set the cruise on 85, and it's holding me at 74, and you can see the distance from the Yukon in front of us. That's about 1.5 to 2 car lengths. So that's as close as you're going to be able to get on and get to someone. It's just enough room to allow a jackass to cut in front of you. And when he does that, then this thing automatically just kind of slows down, throws you forward. I don't like that part. I wish it would allow you to get just least a little bit closer so someone would be less tempted to cut in front of you, and that way you can have a smoother cruise. But that's for me that likes to run 80 to 85 in the fast lane. If you're a 70 mile per hour, 65 mile per hour driver, you're probably not going to have that problem as much, because you're going to be over here on the slow side where everybody's kind of taking it easy. As you can see, we're just comfortably, you know, cruising along, 72, you know, just chilling out. It's adjusting based on what the cars in front of us are doing. I will say my 2015 Passat, which I also did a review on, had a smaller rim on it. I can't remember what's on this car. I think it's 19s or 18s. And my 15 Passat was just a midline version. It was called the Limited model. And it did not have but a 17-inch wheel. And it had a taller tire. And it rode a little bit quieter than this car. Not as much road noise. These larger rims, these SEO rims and Bridgestone tires do transmit a little bit more tire and road noise. I can tell that for sure. There's the blind spot monitoring lighting up. That Honda Odyssey passed us. Alright. Oh, I forgot I was in sport mode. When you're in sport mode, it likes to do some downshifting for you to engine brake. Soft touch. Sorry, I keep getting that up there, guys. Am I still running? Yeah, soft touch materials here. You know, plastic, but a nice grain feel to it. You know, a little cheapness there, but it feels, it's solid. I mean, that sucker's screwed on. This is soft touch with some graining. You've got the little chrome strip running down through there again, along with the wood grain. Of course, all this is soft touch. That's got a nice smooth feel, even though it's, you know, just plastic. It's very smooth and feels nice in the hand. Some nice curves. I mean, it still handles well. I mean, it doesn't wallow much. It's not a sports car, of course. I mean, it's, but I mean, for something that people have been comparing to a Buick these days, it handles a hell of a lot better than the last Buick I drove, which was probably about, you know, a 92 LeSabre. I'm sure the newer Buicks are a little more European tuned. Here's a whoop-de-doo. Hang on. I love this hill. Whoa. You got some nice ambient lighting. I don't know if you can see that in the floorboard. See my foot lit up down there? Got some nice ambient lighting that stays on. There's just a little hint of it down there as well. That's kind of cool. That's a nice feature. At least I think so. I wish they made this car in a wagon for the United States. It's ridiculous. Bring me a damn Passat wagon. I'll own three of them. Well, no, two, because my daughter wouldn't drive one. I mean, these are some pretty good twisty roads here. We're humming along, guys. I mean, this 30 mile per hour zone, I'm running 55, so yeah, if we get stopped, we're in deep crap. But yeah, where's... Whoa, somebody pulls out in front of me. Watch this thing beep at me. Beep. There you go. Just pull on out there, Meemaw. Pull on out, Meemaw. seat space. I'm 6'3 with the afro. Look at that. I mean, I crossed my legs back here, dude. Great leg room back here. This is a private drive. I guess I better get out of here. But I did want to just show you a little walk around real quick of the car. It's got the nice LEDs. It's got the nice LED lights. Those are nice. Just a great elegant design. I like how they did the hood. Let's see. 18s, yeah. A little lower profile tire, so it rides a little rougher. Rougher. That sheriff's got on his lights. I thought he was coming for me. He's pulling over the guy in front of him, I think. Let's outrun him. Because I hit 60 right there, but I think he was going after the guy right in front of him. That was close. That was close. No brake lights, idiot. Good strong brakes, man. I love these brakes. I think it's got great pedal feel. Good pedal feel. Nice, good climate control. Very cold AC. Good heat. The heat fires up quick too on a cold morning. One thing I've always liked about these Volkswagens, they warm up real quick on a cold morning. Heated seats are good and toasty. So for basically, I mean, Volkswagen's discounting the shit out of these things, y'all. I mean, you know, a car that has real leather, a pretty fair amount of tech with self-parking and all the automated cruise and blind spot and emergency braking and rear traffic alert, dual power seats, real leather, a Fender audio system. I mean, a nice, elegant design sunroof, the biggest damn trunk you're gonna find in this class. And the biggest backseat you're going to find in this class and probably the class above. This rear seat reminds me of... This rear seat is bigger than my mom's Lexus LS 460. So, I mean, you can get this car for under 30K with just a little pressure. Yeah, the window sticker's 33, you know, thousands, some change somewhere in there. Yeah, you can walk in there and get a 4K discount right off the bat. So, take my word for it, folks. It's a great car, great value. Those are two. And, you can't go wrong, man. Hope you enjoyed my video. Y'all have a good night.